negro dulce hogar. Reina que un día fue la alegría de todo aquel sitial. Lágrimas vierte la sitiería que tiende a desolar. Y es por no verte, reina, que un día fuiste de aquel lugar. Ya el jilguero se alejó de aquel frondoso algarrobo.
Hi, this is Pete with Video Cafe, and I'm here with Victor Crichton of the Tango Society of Tampa. Did I get that right? Is it?
Well, we don't have an official name like that, but that's close enough.
Okay. Now, why tango? How long have you been doing it?
Well, I've been doing tango off and on actually for about 15 years, but in this area pretty consistently for the last 5 years.
Fantastic. And how many people do you have in your society?
Thousands. No, in this area we have probably about 100 people that are sporadic tango aficionados, and probably about 40 that are hardcore.
Now, the show has got some real stars from Argentina.
Yes, we every year, this is the fifth year we've produced this show, and we always bring two couples, and then we fill the show with some of us local talent. But our two couples this year were Diego DeFalco and Carolina Zokalski from Forever Tango, which was the longest lasting Broadway show, the longest lasting tango show on Broadway.
Okay.
And the other couple, Mora Godoy and Junior Servilla, are directly from Argentina. They came here just for this event, and they're currently starring on a show in Argentina called Tanguera, which is brand new and is about to travel to Europe.
But it's very exciting to watch. What does a judge look for when they are judging tango specifically?
Well, that's an interesting question too, because we don't really have very much competition in Argentine tango. The ballroom people do a lot of competition. And actually, next week is the one time of the year that they do an Argentine tango competition.
Ah.
And it's actually a world championship. And the unfortunate thing is it is judged by the ballroom judges who don't really understand the difference.
Oh, really? So they're not tango specialists then?
They do the ballroom tango, which is very different.
Now, there's a lot of fierce staring into the eyes. Well, what's all that about?
Well, tango is all about passion.
Passion or sex?
Well, you know, some people think that any kind of dancing is some sort of foreplay, and the origins of tango about 150 years ago in Argentina, you know, was, well, they say it got brought up in the bordellos, so...
Isn't it very difficult to learn? I mean, wouldn't it take you years to get good at tango?
Well, people ask me that all the time, and I always say that tango is very easy to learn but very difficult to master.
Okay, okay. Well, that's interesting. So you could start right away, really, once you know a few steps.
Yeah, absolutely. The tango, different than the ballroom tango, is that it's all improvisational, and it's we compare it to learning a language, that you learn some basic words and then you start to converse, and as you get more proficient, your language becomes perhaps a little more poetic.
So the routines we saw at the show, were they choreographed or were they pretty much made up on the spot?
50-50. Each couple has their own preference. A lot of the couples, when they dance on stage, do prefer to choreograph, but a lot of it was improvisational.
Oh, that's great. And where did the tango start exactly? Is it South American?
Yes, in Buenos Aires, Argentina, and also in Montevideo, Uruguay, which are two cities. It's kind of similar to here. We have St. Pete and Tampa on opposite sides of Tampa Bay.
Uh-huh.
And there's a river, the River Plate, that runs between Argentina and Uruguay. And the port area of both those cities is where the origins of tango are from.
How long ago did it start? How old is the tango?
Well, there's not any true documented history, but as far as we can tell, probably around 1870.
Oh, that's quite recent then.
Relatively speaking, compared to some things, but if you're comparing, for instance, to you know, the U.S. dance swing and things like that, then they started in this, well, not no longer this century, but say 1920 and around that era. So tango is older than most of the current social dances that are in existence.
And it's got some connection to the flamenco, I can see.
Only because they're both of Hispanic heritage, but okay. But dance-wise, nothing direct.
Several movies have featured a tango, including one with Schwarzenegger, I seem to remember.
Yeah, that was
clumping around the dance floor.
That was True Lies, and he actually danced tango twice in that show, once with Jamie Lee Curtis and
right.
Once with, I don't remember the other villainess's name, but also, of course, Al Pacino made a big stir with Scent of a Woman with the tango scene in that.
Right, yeah.
And then there were two movies specifically about tango, more art house type movies. One was called The Tango Lesson, which was very, very popular, starring Pablo Varone, who is a true tango dancer. And then about a year later, there was a movie called Tango by a famous director, Carlos Suara. And that movie was actually Academy Award nominated as a best foreign film.
Okay. Now, what about Marlon Brando, Last Tango? Did they actually dance the tango in that?
They did, but it was more of a caricature than, they were almost poking fun at it more than anything.
Okay.
But there is another upcoming movie that hasn't yet been released, a new one that's being distributed now. It's made by Robert Duvall. It's called Assassination Tango. And I've just heard that it will have its debut in the Toronto Film Festival in about a week.
Cool. Now, the music that goes with tango, it has to be tango music,
yes.
Right? Or can you dance the tango to other types of music?
Well, that's a very broad question. Some people believe that you can dance it to anything, and then the tango extremists say if it's not tango music, it's not tango.
And so. We heard some stuff by a modern band as well.
At
the show.
The history of tango, again, is about 150 years old, and a lot of people, the extremists, really believe that if it's anything beyond the 1950s, it's not true tango music. And in the early part of the 1950s, Astor Piazzolla started writing a very modern type of music that had jazz and classical influences and has been referred to as tango nuevo. But again, the purists don't really believe that it's tango music. Personally, I think it's beautiful and it's wonderful music. Then more recently, within the last year, there's a group from Europe called the Gotan Project. Right. And they have written some things now that also have some classical tango musicians playing with them. But we tend to refer to it almost as techno tango because it has kind of that sound.
Right.
And whether it lasts or not remains to be seen, but it's very interesting and it does definitely have the feel of tango.